suddenly an abrupt shift right there.
Cut right there.
Yeah, cut right there. Cut as we know, it's a plane. And then
very
it's big. And now it's very big. And it stays bigger and bigger and bigger. And I think now you hold the level of it. It keeps up as we can keep it.
To rush at the wind and having caught it, to climb as high as the wind itself. To soar. To hover serene beyond reality. To look out to a horizon without bound. To come home. To return to the world again. For the people of Eastern Airlines, the miracle, the exaltation, the serenity of flight are a ceaseless wonder. Come share it with us.
I think the advertising man is in a certain sense unique because he's probably part artist, part businessman, part scientist, I guess, because of all of the facets of the business of marketing that he gets involved with, the creative side of it. I think all of it can be creative in one sense or another.
Introducing chicken tetrazzini, lasagna, and manigot. Some people think it's the cast of a Dolce Vita. Mm-hmm. Introducing lasagna. Some people think it's an Italian opera.
Mm-hmm. Well, I'll tell you, one of the things that I think is not strong here and isn't coming off for me at all is the fact that this is a frozen product.
There's more to Italian food than veal parmesan. Let's start with chicken tetrazzini,
mm-hmm.
which, you know, we all feel is a very, very strong concept.
If in any of the advertising the chef is going to become an important personality, I'm not sure that this isn't the advertising where he should be most important.
The inside story of lasagna.
Mm-hmm.
Lasagna explained.
So, yeah, well, we could weave the chef into this one very easily.
I think
too.
The chef has to be a major
element. Well, he could tell the inside story.
Right.
He could be, you know, the expose.
The inside story of manicotti is explained by Chef Boyardee.
Mm-hmm.
The inside story of chicken tetrazzini.
Where did chicken tetrazzini originate?
He might have originated in Brooklyn for all I know. Here's announcing the opening of a great Italian restaurant, your home.
Stevie? What are we going to do this afternoon?
Well, I promised Peter and Jamie that we'd go bike riding through the zoo.
I wanted to go to Green Branch and do a little antiquing.
You better go back in the
line before I come through. And then? Can you take one
bike this one? Well, I don't know, Jamie, though. I don't think it's really working. I don't even need to ride it. You're on the
He can go on the handlebars. He'll just take three bites.
Okay.
Okay.
Great.
Come on, you want to put the corn muffins in your help?
Yes!
Yeah.
I'm going to do it all.
Okay, you do it all. You can put a little more than that in each one, Jamie. Jamie, answer the phone, please.
Come on, Jamie, get it for me, will you?
Hello? Who is it?
Is it for me? Who is it?
Yes, Uncle Mike.
Is it Uncle Mike for me?
Hi. Oh, fine, how are you? Susie had to go to the antique store first, and then we were going to pick up the bikes and go over to the zoo. You want to meet us here? Oh, okay, great. Come on, let's go. How will that be? Come on.
Goodbye.
In a couple of hours. Bye.
Wait for us.
Here's the show. Here it is, it's right here.
Look at
that.
I want my
music.
Thank you.
Yeah, well, you remember who broke it?
I broke the one.
Yeah, I think Jamie did. My feeling personally is that when I put something on a page or on a television screen, I'm selling it to the public, and that public happens to also include my family, my children. And there is an obligation that we have because of the power of the page, or the channel, if you will, to have the highest ethics.
Trim it off, and you'll get what's going on.
What are you doing?
What is happening in here?
What are you doing?
Something, personal job.
Freelance.
We're trimming that. What's going on?
In the middle of bread.
What is that?
Okay. Jerry, what's happening on the... What's happening on the stuff that... the Italian stuff?
They went out, I just saw Mortensen sent them a very strong letter the other day saying that they really ought to do it.
Right, isn't April probably a good time to
shoot? Yeah, we're still aiming for the first week in April.
First week in April.
Second week.
You don't have much time now.
No, just 3 or 4 weeks.
Can you let me know as soon as you find me?
Yeah, I will.
Okay, thanks. I will. Alan, I love your opening. Terrific. What is this? This spell?
That's seamless, Steve.
That's great.
We try to achieve a subtle design effect.
What happened?
Well, that's what they're putting the paper on, Steve.
Oh, it's lovely. I hope you fix it. I think it's going to be terrific when the spell's in.
Well, I like it.
Goodbye.
So long, Steve.